Today, we are bringing you along on an attraction we love in the Outer Banks of North Carolina, a wild horse safari. We posted a YouTube short with a bit of footage from this experience earlier, but in today's slightly longer video, we are going to talk about the details of the experience and review the Wild Horse Safari attraction.
This is the ride vehicle we traveled in. There are several companies that offer this type of tours in Corolla, North Carolina. The one we went with was Corolla Jeep Adventures. They also offer ATV tours, kayaking tours, and Jeep tours where you can actually drive one of their Jeeps along the beach. The Wild Horse Safari option we went with is a ride in an open safari truck over about 25 miles of beaches looking for the wild horses of Corolla, ending with a stop on the top of Penny Hill. We'll show you what that is in a bit. The safari truck seat up to about 12 people, and it was sold out when we went, so social distancing wasn't really possible, but we did wear our masks throughout.
This is the main office where participants meet up about half an hour before the ride. There are a lot of forms to sign when you arrive, stipulating that you realize there is some danger involved in riding on the beach in open vehicles and that you can't hold the company responsible in case of injury or worse. Once the paperwork is done, it's time to load into the trucks where the driver explains what you can expect.
We ride north up North Carolina Highway 12 until suddenly the road ends and you pull right out onto the beach. This is referred to as the four-wheel drive beach. You do not have to be on a tour to ride on the beach. You can drive on it yourself as long as you have a four-wheel drive vehicle. In fact, as you travel north along the beach, you eventually come to neighborhoods of beach houses that can't be accessed by any paved roads. You have to drive up the beach to get to these neighborhoods. Some of these beach houses along the sand roads can be rented if you have four-wheel drive vehicles, and that sounds like fun. You can actually get several miles away from the busyness of civilization on your vacation to the Outer Banks.
The tour guide driving our truck was very interesting, stopping occasionally to point things out. The difficult part of any kind of safari attraction involving animals in the wild is, of course, that the animals may not cooperate. We really did have to look around the beach and through the neighborhoods to find them. There were several times other people involved in looking after the wild horses would stop and talk to our tour guide to let him know where some horses were recently spotted. The horses we were on the lookout for were from a herd of about 100 Spanish mustangs whose ancestors were brought to the area as part of Spanish explorations of the 1500s. They were abandoned when the explorers made a hasty retreat.
People visiting this area are warned repeatedly not to get close to these horses and not to feed them. The herd has been eating the wild grasses of the islands for over 400 years, so the horses are no longer able to digest most anything else. Well-meaning visitors who tried to feed the horses carrots or apples or other food have made some horses very sick or even dead as a result. So it was made very clear we were to watch the horses from the truck without going any closer.
The whole experience lasts about 2 hours, and we did finally find some horses. I would say we saw horses for about 10 minutes at various points throughout the 2 hours, but we also had a blast riding up and down the beaches looking for them. The horses were all drinking water or eating grass when we saw them, and they truly are beautiful animals. It was a really cold day in December when we did this a few weeks back, and it felt even colder out on the beach, but it was totally worth it. These tours are available all year long, so just be sure to bring a coat if you go in the winter.
Our trip ended with a ride up Penny Hill. This is a large sand dune that's on private land. It's actually the second largest sand dune in the Outer Banks. We visited the largest sand dune on the East Coast, which is in the Outer Banks, on our trip last summer. There's footage of that in our Nag's Head video, which we'll link in the description and at the end of this video. Anyway, Penny Hill gave us a good view of the beach and the beach houses along the coast. If you take the ATV tour with Corolla Jeep Adventures, you actually get to drive an ATV up and down Penny Hill in addition to driving along the beach, which we might do next time because that sounds like a lot of fun.
including tax, our two-hour tour was just under $50 per person, and we really enjoyed it. We highly recommend doing a wild horse tour with Corolla Jeep Adventures. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button as well as subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time we post. I'm Alice.
And I'm Jack.
And we'll see you the next time we're traveling through.